So in the video of today, a little bit over here in like a party, Christmas vibe, I have here the Tronesmart Bang EC. Now we'll compare it to the Wildbox. So even though the prices are completely different these days, in the beginning the Wildbox, its price was very close to the Tronesmart Bang EC. But Miva did do some like software improvements, also some hardware improvements. Like for example, this is a newer version than the other one that I had before. And this one, for example, is a little bit better bass response. It's also a little bit louder and the overall build has been put a little bit better together. So the Tronesmart looks actually very similar in size. Of course, you do have this like carrying strap. I will put that over to the side because it can be a little bit annoying. So here we have the speakers side to side. So the Tronesmart is a bit bigger. It's also like a bit more down, so the Miva, even though it's a little bit less in the length, is a little bit higher up in the housing. So this one is using two full range drivers, so no like tweeters or anything else. I do have to say that the overall audio quality is this, yeah, it's just there. It's just good. It's not like the best speaker out there, of course, also not with the Miva. But for the 70 euros or the 80 euros, somewhere between those prices, it has a decent sound. And the sound pulse EQ on this speaker, as with the, like the Tronesmart Bang Mini, is pretty good actually. So I do recommend to use it. I will also be using it in a comparison that I will do after my talking. So with the Miva you do have tweeters. You also have like full range drivers, but those are like more in the bass and the midtones. And I do have to be honest that the drivers in the Miva are a little bit higher quality. So this means the drivers are very similar to the Xtreme 3. And there's also like neodymium drivers. I'm not sure with the Tronesmart, I didn't like remove the drivers yet. I'm not sure if I will, because the speaker grill removing is okay, but this housing is more complete together. So with the Miva it's easier to like repair or move away apart. So yeah, let's just go to an audio test so you guys can see how they perform. I can say that the Miva is a little bit better in the deeper bass side, but with the Tronesmart it's not a very bad sounding speaker. It has either some treble, but the Miva also wins a little bit there in the clarity above. I do think that for 70 euros, 80 euros, and this one is even like these days around 120, 140 euros I believe, It's a very decent budget speaker. Of course, the Miva, if you want to pay a little bit more, is a little bit better choice. But it really depends on what you like. For example, with ThroneSpot you do get more lights, so even on the drivers, and they do work a little bit better on the music than with the Miva overall with like mid-tones. So with the Miva it's definitely more focused on the bass side. It's also fine, but it works a little bit different. And I do think that the weight on the ThroneSpot is a little bit heavier. The battery life is also maybe a little bit better on this one. I will be honest, I'm not really like testing out battery lives on Bluetooth speakers, because that one person is like using it on 50%, the other person could do it on 70%. There are also people that are using like on 100%. So on 100% with this kind of size speakers, you do really have to keep in mind that the overall battery life will be a few hours most of the time. But if you use it on 50%, you can get very close to the rated battery life overall. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and see you guys around.